After 34 long years, the victims of the 1984 anti-Sikh riots have been granted justice. Congress leader Sajjan Kumar has been found to be guilty in the case and sentenced to a lifetime in prison. The Delhi High Court's verdict was also a huge victory for H.S. Phoolka, a senior advocate who was the key petitioner in the case and has persisted with it for over three decades. Joining us now to speak about this journey is Mr. Phoolka. Thank you for speaking with us here at Bloomberg Quint. I want to start by asking you to summarize how it feels to get to this verdict after the long journey. This has been documented in more than one place as one of the most arduous legal cases, and you've seen it through.
This is a great day, and it's a great victory, not only for me, and not only for the victims, but for the whole nation. This judgment has sent a very clear and loud message to the people who are in power and commit crime, just thinking that they can go scot-free using their powerful positions. I mean, this is a clear message to them that law can catch up with you one day. Be careful when you commit these crimes. And like Sajjan Kumar, he was young when he committed these crimes. Now, the old days he will spend in jail. So this is a clear warning to those people in power who committed these crimes for their for some political gains. And so that the day may come that you may spend your old days of life in jail. So this is a big development, and it's a great victory for the nation and our judicial system.
Yeah, Mr. Phoolka, Sajjan Kumar, it is being reported, will move the Supreme Court for a review. That we do not know how much time it will take. At the end of it, speaking to you, you're of course an inspiring figure because of your persistence. But for the victims and for people who are looking at the Indian judicial system through this case, there will definitely be a question of whether it's all worth it. That justice does come at the end, but is it just taking too long? Again, this decision will be challenged in a higher court.
You see, under the law, he is entitled to challenge in the Supreme Court, but I am certain the Supreme Court will not entertain it, and we will oppose it. So I am sure that the Supreme Court will not grant him any relief, and he will have to face the rest of his life in the jail.
Yes, but I am talking about the time it takes for any such kind of a case to reach its logical conclusion, and what that says for the judicial system in this country and for people who are waiting for justice in numerous cases.
So you cannot call it a delay of judicial system. This was a systematic attempt by the government, by the whole machinery, now to shield these people. You see the judgment, go through the judgment, you would know it. It is not only the judicial system, but the system was never made to even act. The case started in 2005, after 21 years. And the judgment says the police, the administration, even the judiciaries, everybody is responsible in scuttling the process. So it's not one of those cases of a delay, normal case. Now, it was a total game of the government, of this the whole system, to shield the guilty and not let the case move.
Mr. Phoolka, I want to hear from you what this has meant for you personally, because it has been a big part of your life over the last so many years, nearly three decades. And what has it meant for your personal journey, the sacrifices you and your family have had to make?
Personally, it means a lot to me, mainly three things. I resigned from the post of leader of opposition, having a minister's status, to appear in this case because the Bar Council had said that I cannot appear in this case. Though I had applied that I am doing it free of any charges, so allow me, they didn't allow me. So I resigned from it. That's one. Number two, it also is, a, I mean, it's a kind of, it shows to the people, to the other people who are fighting for some cause, for some good cause, that persistence will always show results. don't just get disillusioned by some failures and don't give up. If you continue falling and one day you will succeed, it means a lot. And when I resigned from the leader of opposition, some people were saying this is a mad person, made for a dead cause, he has given up the minister status. Now, I am proven right, and all those people who were thinking that, saying that, they are proven wrong today. So, as far as personally I am concerned, my family is concerned, this means a lot.
Has it been worth it, all of this struggle and all of this fight? And do you think that justice has completely been done? Because there are more names out there, there are more cases out there.
You see, justice has not been done at all. It's a symbolic justice. It's a symbol. But in this case, even with the attempts by the powerful people, powerful government, I mean, even the symbolic justice is enough. So I feel that I was fighting for this to show that in this country, nobody is above law. If a person commits a crime, you will be punished. So that I have succeeded in that. At least in the symbolic justice only, that we have shown it and we have proven it. So success is concerned, at this stage, even this symbolism is a lot.
Just one more question about Mr. Kamal Nath. He's of course been sworn in as Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister, and a number of people are raising questions about him because he has been named by some eyewitnesses. What is your comment on the whole controversy over him being sworn in today?
You see, there is very strong evidence against Kamal Nath. We have been presenting it in the commissions, in the courts, to the police, everywhere, but no case has been registered against Kamal Nath. His name, he was the first leader whose name appeared in the media that he was leading the mob. On 2nd November 84 itself, Indian Express carried the name of Kamal Nath that he was leading a mob at Gurdwara Rakabganj, where 2 Sikhs were killed and Gurdwara was set on fire. On 3rd November 84, his name appeared in the Statesman. And so the reporter who had seen Kamal Nath, the reporter of Indian Express, Sanjay Suri, he gave his affidavit before Mishra Commission way back in 1985. And for Nanavati Commission also, he came all the way from England. Now he settled in England to depose and depose that he has seen Kamal Nath. But in spite of all this, no case has been registered against him. Now, after this judgment, and 2 weeks back, there was another judgment of Delhi High Court where 88 people were convicted. On the basis of these two judgments, this gives a lot of strength to our case. And now we are quite hopeful that we will succeed in convincing the SIT to register a case against Kamal Nath and prosecute him for murder.
So your battle for justice continues, Mr. Phoolka. It doesn't end here.
No, definitely. It will continue. It will not end with this. The struggle for justice will continue.
You know, the Supreme Court has also talked about in its judgment about other, heinous riots that this country has seen. Do you think there is a message there for those victims as well?
Very, very, there's a hope given to those victims that don't give up, fight. And this is a message and warning to those people who commit these kind of things, like lynching and others, that you may have power today, you may, for some time, you may be able to stall the wheels of justice. But ultimately, the law might catch up with you after decades. The crimes which you are committing in your young age, you might have to spend whole of your old days in jail, like it's the case of Sajjan Kumar. So it's a big warning to that. That's how judgment is relevant even today's context also.
All right. Thank you so much for speaking with us, Mr. Phoolka, and congratulations for your victory and your continued persistence.